Oh my goodness, your grandmother would not be pleased. I'm pleased right now. Look at this. This is so cool. Oh my goodness. I need like an hour to talk to this dude. Check this out. Limited edition Padres pins. And they're only available to 5,000 fans. This dude here. Here to share how you can get your hands on them. Do you want these? Do you want them? My man Dewey Keithley is the owner and the co-founder of Players Pins. Dewey, good morning.
Good morning. Thanks for having me.
You know, I saw you coming out, setting this up, and I'm like, oh, what's this? Yeah. Give me a little background, a little history. How long has your company been around? How long have you been doing this? And where did the idea come from?
Yeah, good question. So we've been around about a year only.
That's it.
Yeah, so here in San Diego, born and raised, love the Padres. So
of course.
The fact that we're working with the Padres is kind of a dream. But we just started here in San Diego.
So you just kind of dropped that knowledge, like, yeah, kind of working with the Padres is cool. It doesn't just happen that way, man. You can start a year ago and say, I'm going to make these pins, but how do you get the meeting with the Padres, and how do you get them to say, you know what, this is great, it's a good product, it represents us well, let's go.
Yeah, I actually broke in just kidding. It was actually not very hard because we had an original prototype and they were really excited about how it looked.
So, is that the ones that you were saying these are the original?
Original prototype. There's only one of these things, so this is super rare. And it's pretty funky looking right now compared to like
this is the one you'll get on the 21st.
It's pretty fun. Kids love them. Collectors really love them.
I love how you can tell the difference between the two.
You don't want to get that one. Yeah, it's grown.
What makes the pins special? There's something about them. It's just, what is it?
So we actually filed our patent. So these are patent protected on how you can display them.
Whoa.
Which is really cool. So it's essentially a baseball card style with a pin, because you can't get these. Normally when you get a pin, it comes in like a bag. And that's it. But these are like, people are getting them autographed, not opening the seal because they're like, these to grow in value. So it's
because I was going to say it's reminiscent of buying baseball cards. You know what I mean? It's the presentation and everything else. That's pretty cool.
Yeah.
The latest releases, obviously, you've been around only a year. So what are some of the latest things you have?
So we've got, obviously, the Padres. So April 21st, we're doing Ha-Seon Kim and Fernando Tatis Jr. And then July 14th, we'll be doing No-No Joe and Campy with the Padres. And then the big ones, August 20th is Manny Machado. We're also doing stuff with the Rangers, as you can see. So they won the World Series last year, so they wanted to do a limited run there. We did some with the Brooklyn Nets. The Anaheim Ducks was our first deal. So they're like the team that owns the San
It's like
Diego
you get
Club.
Your foot in the door with the Padres. There's like everybody calls everyone and tells everybody, and all of a sudden now you got all these other teams and all these other leagues coming to you.
Yeah, we're pumped.
What is the potential here long term in terms of what you have for visualized for this company?
Yeah, so we want to be in every stadium, in every arena. Essentially, everyone knows the bobblehead. We want everyone to know players' pins and to have these for collectibles for years to come.
I love that Camposano one.
It's got the earring.
So explain, you mentioned on the 21st of April.
Yeah.
Oh, that's Little League Day, by the way.
Yeah.
A bunch of Little League teams are going to be there. So you mentioned Ha-Seon Kim and Tatis.
Yeah.
Does everybody get one, and which one do you get, and how is that going to work? Because, you know, I'm going to that game for Little League, so I need to know, do I need to get there early? Which one am I going to get? How's that work?
Yeah, so how it works is you need a special ticket called a theme game ticket.
Uh-huh.
Only 5,000 people will get them.
Oh, my God.
So, and you can't buy these anywhere else.
Right.
So this is the only place you can get them. So 5,000, then it's out. You'll just need to go to padres.com/themegames.
And then later on, there's a couple other games that you can get them to.
So Joe Musgrove and Luis Campusano will be in July.
Yeah. Same rules apply?
Same rules, it's a theme game.
And each one of those also 5,000 pins only?
That's 5,000 only.
Oh, man.
And then later in August is an all fans, so 40,000 of the Manny Machado of this one right here. So,
get out the bubblegum one?
Yeah, so it's Canals sponsored that one. But yeah, it's
this is so cool!
Yeah,
this is where I lose all professionalism. I say, this is awesome! congrats, dude. That's amazing.
I mean,
and for a fan to kind of have this and have that success, that must make you feel so cool.
Oh, yeah, we're so pumped to be to be working with the Padres and being here in San Diego. So.
By the way, what kind of sorcery is going on
here? Oh, yeah, this is voodoo. Yeah.
Absolute sorcery.
Yeah, it's pretty futuristic.
It's like floating.
Yeah.
Where do you get one of these things? What happens if I put like my card under it?
It'll work. It'll still work.
Get out of here, really?
I swear.
Let's try it. Ready?
Not even kidding.
You ready for this?
Okay, let's see it.
Sorcery! Yes, sir! All right, we're looking forward to this whole year. It's going to be fun with these giveaways, so we appreciate it.
Thank you.
Thank you so much, Dua, and the player pins. This is awesome. This is for Padres fans, right here.
Yeah,
we'll be right back.